Is that a unicorn? Well, to many people it is. just like me, up until about 2 months ago, I've only heard of the Kel-Tec Sub 2000, never really saw one in person. I've been searching for one of these for quite a long time. More specifically, I was looking for the Glock 17 model. And, you know, everywhere I asked on the different gun forums, on, you know, gun stores and all that, I just kept getting laughed at and saying, good luck, good luck, good luck. Looked at a gun broker, and people were selling them for $500 and up, and kind of decided to give up on it. However, one thing that I did do is about a year and a half ago is put my name on a list at my local gun store. And just as I had forgotten about it, got a phone call saying, hey, got one that you're looking for. The only problem is it's got the stainless tube and barrel instead of the all black. At that point, I could give two shits whether it was a pink barrel. Wanted to just get my hands on it. This is a great, great little carbine. For those of you who don't know, this is a Kel-Tec. This is my only Kel-Tec. I never wanted a Kel-Tec anything except for this one. I think that just the design is amazing. I've heard nothing but great things about it. And I know a lot of people are really, really happy with theirs. And anyway, let me kind of show you here how this works. And I'm sure most of you probably know, but let me get this magazine out. Okay. So the Kel-Tec Sub 2000 basically is a 9mm carbine that folds in half. And let me unfold it here. And what you do is you've got this little latch right there. And you just press down and it just unfolds. And voila. Like I said before, greatest thing about this is it takes the Glock 17 magazines. So if you have a Glock 17, if you have a Glock 19, if you have a Glock 26, the magazines are now interchangeable. So that is the beauty of it. It came with one 10-round magazine. It's a Glock factory mag, but it's a 10-round only. So I went out and bought a bunch of these 17 rounds, Glock 17 magazines, and also bought four of these. And these are the scary, scary, scary magazines that everybody's talking about. Obviously I'm being sarcastic, but anyway, these are the 33 rounders. They are Glock factory 33 rounders. I got a great deal on them. I caught them on a sale right before all the madness happened, and basically trying to find some of these right now is practically impossible. Probably just as hard as trying to find one of these. So these are a lot of fun, especially at the range. I mean, it looks ridiculous. However, you know, at the range, I don't want to sit there and spend my time reloading magazines. Things I like about this. I've shot it several times. The reason I've been shooting it a lot is because according to Kel-Tec, according to the Kel-Tec forums, according to many gun forums, according to pretty much everything that I've read, is that these require a break-in. The break-in is anywhere from 300 to 600 rounds, and apparently it also prefers, during that break-in period, 147 grain 9mm. Well, unfortunately, a while back, I stocked up on a shitload of 115 grain 9mm. And when I say shitload, I mean a lot. So I was not about to go out and buy 147 grain when I had plenty of 9mm in-house. So unfortunately, I have to deal with a lot of failure feeds, tons of stovepipes. The stovepipes generally happen on the last round. And according to everybody, this is very common until the break-in period is over. So I am now up to right around 500, and my stovepipes are, I'm still getting them, but not as much as I did in the beginning. I have to tell you, it's pretty freaking annoying to go to the range and just have to deal with it, but I am willing to go through the process, the break-in process, I guess, to get it over with. And unfortunately, I feel like I'm really wasting my money just kind of breaking it in. However, it is a lot of fun. I am having a lot of fun doing it. It is super accurate, tons of fun. we took this thing out to just about 75 yards, and it was just amazingly accurate. So here are my pros. My pros is, takes Glock magazines. It folds in half, and I'll show you how that how it folds in half a little bit later. And super accurate, very light, feels like a toy almost. And when it folds, it fits nicely in a small backpack that I have. And that it shares magazines with my other guns. So those are my pros. The cons, obviously, break-in period. Two, this charging handle right here. Probably one of the most uncomfortable charging handles. I mean, it is just brutal. I'm sure it'll get easier as this gets broken into. Like I said, I can't talk today. Once the gun is broken in, it will get a lot smoother. But this is probably the most uncomfortable thing ever. I know they have some aftermarket parts that that basically resolve this issue. Another thing that I don't like is when you are at an indoor range and you are wearing ear protection. Generally, I wear just some of these right here. Nothing special, but they work. But when you're wearing ear protection, it is very, very hard to get a cheek weld on here. And I figured out a way to do it, but again, it's just not very comfortable. Now, outdoors is a different story, because outdoors I just wear plugs, and it's great. Indoors, just very, very uncomfortable. Another thing, too, is this front sight. Let's see if I can get you guys to see it here. This front sight right here, it's just very flimsy. When you adjust it, you have to be very, very careful. Excuse me. You have to be very, very careful. It's very flimsy and it tends to break. I haven't done it, but I've read a lot that a lot of people trying to adjust their front sight have done it. So just be careful with that. So those are my pros and cons. Again, to me, the pros outweigh the cons. I just can't wait to get this thing broken in and so I can rely on it. But right now, to me, it's just kind of a work in progress. But regardless, I wanted to share it with you guys and let you know my thoughts. If you have any additional information, maybe something I didn't mention, please let me know, as I am new to this rifle, to this carbine. And you know, the more information you can give me, the better. And I would definitely appreciate it. So finally, to put it back in its folded state, you kind of have to pull on the trigger guard right here, like that. You kind of open that like that. So you hold it, go like this, and it folds, and then right up here, let's see if I can get it right in the camera here, right up here, it clicks, like that. They also give you a little key, so you can keep this locked. I'm silly, but yeah, I'll never use that. But anyway, great little gun, fun gun. Can't wait to get it broken in. I'll be sure to give you guys a range report once I feel that this gun's functioning properly, and hopefully it will. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any questions.